Good morning, everybody. Hearty welcome you all on behalf of NIMI Chennai. I am S. Sivarasu from NSTA Chennai. Today, we are going to discuss about ordinary depth gauge. First, we will see the objectives. Number one, state the uses of ordinary depth gauge. Number two, name the parts of ordinary depth gauge. Number 3, state the care and maintenance of ordinary depth gauge. In modern industry, there are so many types of instruments are using according to the job profile and accuracy of job to be checked. An ordinary depth gauge typically refers to is a semi-precision measuring instrument that is used by mechanical engineers, manufacturing engineers, and among others to accurately obtain the measurement of depth of bored cavity, recess, holes, grooves or other similar openings, etc. Depth gauge is used to measure the job with an accuracy of 0.5 mm, that is steel rule accuracy. Next, we'll see the parts of ordinary depth gauge. Number 1, graduated beam. Number 2, clamping screw. Number 3, scale, that is steel rule. Number 4, base. Now we will see the one by one in detail. Number 1, graduated beam. The beam with main scale graduation in the sliding member or part, in this graduated beam available the ranges of 0 to 200 mm. Number 2, clamping screw. The clamping screw is used to lock or tightening after adjustment is made according to the job height. Number 3, scale or rule. In this scale, main scale divisions are marked to up to full length of beam. Each main scale division value is 1 mm. Here, subdivisions are marked 0.5 mm also. At the end of the scale or rule, the relief is given at the end of the beam of depth gauge is to avoid the seating in the corners of slots and ensures the correct reading. Next, base. The base is the fixed unit and serves as a datum for measurement. It also carries the vernier scale and vernier graduation. Next, care and maintenance of ordinary depth gauge. Number 1, thoroughly clean and inspect the depth gauge. Number 2, fasten it to the movable jaw correctly. Number 3, set the depth gauge rod with its end its contact with the surface plate and check the if any error. Number 4, raise the movable jaw to clear the obstruction on the part. Number 5, place depth gauge in position and lower movable jaw until the rod of depth gauge contacts the measured point of the part feature. Number 6, do not give excessive pressure on the beam while taking measurement. We'll lift the base from the reference surfaces. I hope you all understood about the uses of ordinary depth gauge, parts of ordinary depth gauge, finally care and maintenance of ordinary depth gauge. Thank you.